This video, we will see the problems on root locus asked in the competitive examinations. So you refer previous video for some more problems.
The question, the gain at the breakaway point of the root locus of the unity feedback system whose open loop transfer function is given like this. So here they were asking what is the value of gain at the breakaway point for the system having open loop transfer function like this. So here to calculate the breakaway point, first formulate the characteristic equation, then keeping k alone on left side, differentiate dk by ds and d equal to 0. These are the steps involved to find the breakaway point. So using the steps, so 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to 0, that is characteristic equation. Then keep k alone one side, differentiate dk by ds, differentiate k with respect to s. Then when we equate this dk by ds is equal to 0, we have the answer s is equal to plus or minus 2. S is equal to plus or minus 2, this is the breakaway part. Now coming to the problem, we have the g of s open loop function g of s equal to ks divided by s minus 1 into s minus 4. So we will plot these into pole zero diagram. So we have the 0 at the origin, s is equal to 0, we have the first 0, and s is equal to 1, we have the first pole, s is equal to 4, we have the second. So the root locus lies between only in the right side, since there only the poles and zeros are present. Among the two values we have the breakaway point, that is plus 2 and minus 2. There is no chance of having the breakaway point at minus 2. So which is there minus 2. So there is no chance for the breakaway point s is equal to minus 2. So the breakaway point must be a plus 2 having the value like this. Now the problem is asked, what is the value of k at this point? What is the value of k at this point? We have the rule to find k at any point on the root locus. K is equal to lb1, lb2, lb3 going on divided by lz1 multiplied by lz2 going. Now this problem having only two poles and one zero. So this formula is modified into two poles, the length from pole 1, length from pole 2 divided by length from 0, 1. So this is the point of consideration. We have to measure first pole to the point that we have the length is 1. We have the length is 1. Now the second pole to the point that we have the length is 2. So LB1 is 1 and LB2 is 2. That is 1 into 2, again they divided by length from 0, that is 0 to this point, we have the length 2, that is LZ. So LZ value is 2. So when we simplify, we have the K value, gain value at the breakaway point, K is equal to 1. So the choice is 1 is the answer. Next problem. The characteristic equation of a feedback control system is given by like this, where k value is greater than 0 is a scalar variable parameter. In the root locus diagram of the system, the asymptote of the root locus for a larger value of k meet at a point in S plane whose coordinates are. So here they were asking, where is the asymptote meeting point at a real axis? That is the question they were asking. Where is the asymptote meeting at the real axis? That was the question. Now from the, this is a given characteristic equation. So we know the characteristic equation of any control system is 1 plus g of s, h of s equal to 0. So here given, let us assume this is a unity feedback system. For time being, so therefore 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to, we can write the given equation the given characteristic, any given characteristic equation can be denominator plus k times numerator. So we will express the given equation like this. From the given equation, we can formulate the open loop function, open loop transfer function, that is equal to numerator by denominator. From the characteristic equation, we can write open loop transfer function, numerator by denominator, when we write the given equation like this. So this is a given equation. This given equation can be write in this form, that is a denominator plus k times the numerator. This entire term is a denominator plus k times the numerator. So therefore g of s is equal to numerator over denominator. This is the given open loop transfer function from the characteristic equation. So when we simplify this denominator, we have the term like this. Denominator, we have the s power 3. So therefore, we have the three roots in the denominator, three poles in the denominator. When we plot these poles in the pole zero diagram, first pole is located at s is equal to 0, second one is s is equal to minus 2, and the third one is s is equal to minus 3. And of course, we have the 0 at minus 1. Now here the question is asking where is the asymptote meeting at the S plane. That is meaning that the asymptote meeting at the real axis, that is nothing but the centroid point. Centroid formula is sum of poles minus sum of zeros divided by P is number of poles minus number of zeros. So the sum of pole locations are, first pole is located at S is equal to 0. Then second pole is s is equal to minus 2, third one is s is equal to minus 3, minus 0 is located at minus 1, divided by, there are 3 poles, 1, 2, 3, 3 poles, 3, only 1, 0. When we simplify, we have the answer as minus 2. So the centroid point is minus 2. So from the given answer, we can conclude this is the centroid. Next question, and the open loop transfer function g of s of the system is given for a unity feedback system. What is the breakaway point of the root locus on the real axis? So they were asking to find the breakaway point. So straightforward, the rules to find the breakaway point is, first to form the characteristic equation, keep k along one side, then differentiate dk by ds and equal to 0, solve it. So this is the characteristic equation, 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to 0. So 1 plus g of s is given, h of s, they were mentioned as unity feedback, h of s value is 1. So when we simplify this, that is s cube plus k is equal to 0. So here, therefore, keeping k alone one side, second step, keeping k alone one side, remaining two other side, then differentiate k with respect to s, and we have the equation. Then when we equate this equal to 0, it's 3s square plus 6x plus 2. When we solve it, we have the two answer. It is a quadratic equation. When we solve, we have two answer, but among the two, we have to select the one. See, when we look at the pole zero diagram of a given system, the pole zero diagram of the given system is, we have, there is no zero, there is no zero. We have the three poles located at 0, minus 1 and minus 2. So that is 0, minus 1, minus 2. So here, as per the rule, as per the root locus rule, we have the root locus in this point, and also we have the root locus in this point. This is the area we have the root locus. Among the two given breakaway points, so the first point is located at somewhere here. It is minus 0.42. The second root locus, second point is located at somewhere here, that is minus 1.5. But as per the rules, we conclude that in this area there is no root locus. So definitely, this is not the answer, since in that point there is no root locus. We have the root locus on minus 0.42. So minus 0.42, this is the answer. So next question, the root locus of the feedback control system having the characteristic equation where k value is greater than 0 enters in the real axis, enters in the real axis. That means it is something like a break-in point, break-in point. So breaking point, so break-in point or breakaway point, both are having same method, break-in point, BIP, breakaway point or breaking point, both are having same procedure. So here the characteristic equation is given. They were asking what is the breaking point. So this is a standard form of characteristic equation we know, so which can be expressed as some term plus k into some term. So this we will call as new denominator, this will call as numerator. So from the characteristic equation we can write g of s, open loop transfer function, open loop transfer function, g of s equal to numerator by denominator. Now coming to the problem, so this is the problem given, so which can be expressed denominator plus k times numerator. So this is the denominator plus k times numerator. So therefore g of s is equal to 6s divided by s square plus 2s plus 5. When we plot this g of s in pole zero diagram, we have the zero located at s is equal to, we have the zero located at s is equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. When we solve it, we have the two roots are two poles located at, one is located as at minus 1 plus j2 and another one is minus 1 minus j2. So according to the rule of root locus, we conclude that this entire real axis having the root locus. So kindly refer the previous videos how to find what are the steps involved to find the root locus. So refer the video so that you can easily follow. So we conclude that this is the point where this entire real axis having the root locus. Now the root locus starting from this pole coming like this, and root locus starting from this point coming like this, so they will meet at one point that is called a break-in point or breakaway point, meeting one point and changes the direction. So this root locus enters into the real axis and this root locus enters into the real axis. So that we can call it as breakaway point. So we know well the breakaway point rule, keeping after formulate the characteristic equation, keep k alone one side, differentiate k with respect to s, then equate a k is equal to 0. When we equate k, tk by ds is equal to 0, and slowly when we simplify, s is equal to plus root 5 and minus root 5. So plus root 5 is somewhere here, that is this is plus root 5, root 5, this is one choice, and another choice is somewhere here, let us take somewhere, this is minus root 5, minus negative value. So negative value there, root locus meets, so this is minus root 5. So here from the given choice we can conclude my s is equal to minus root 5 is the answer for the given problem. Next question, the characteristic equation of control system is given as this. For the large value of s, the root loci for k greater than 0 are asymptotic to asymptotes. Where do the asymptotes? So it is meaning that the asymptote always starting from the centroid point. So here indirectly they were asking about the centroid. So this is the given characteristic equation, 1 plus g of s, h of s is equal to 0. So let us assume this is a unity feedback system, ideal system. So therefore we can take a g of s is equal to k into s plus 1, s into s plus 4, s square plus 2s plus 2. This is g of s. When we map into the pole zero diagram, we have the 0 at minus 1, pole at first pole is located at 0, the second pole is located at minus 4, and when we solve this we have the roots minus 1 plus j 1 and minus 1 minus j 1. So let us take this is p3 and this is p4. So therefore there are 4 poles and 1 0. So we have the formula for centroid, which from that the asymptote line starts. Centroid is equal to sum of poles minus sum of zeros divided by p minus z. So sum of pole is 0 minus 4 minus 1 plus j 1 minus 1 minus j 1. So sum of poles minus sum of 0 is minus 1 divided by number of poles, that is 4, minus number of 0, that is 1. So when we simplify that, we have the answer minus 5 by 3. So here the answer is minus 5 by 3. This is the answer. Next question. The figure shows the root locus plot, this figure, of a third order system whose open loop transfer function is among the four choice. You have to select one. So we will try using trial and error method. So let us plot the pole zero map. So here we have no zero. We have three poles which are located at s is equal to 0. So here we have the pole. Two poles lies in s is equal to 0, and one pole is starting from minus 1. Here we have for this this one we have the pole. That is origin, we have one pole, and when we simplify we have the answer plus or minus j. So this is somewhere here, this is the pole zero map. Again for this also we have the same, this also we have the same. Okay, so using trial and error method we can conclude all the root locus, as per the rule of root locus, all the root locus must start from the pole. Here two root locus starting from here and one root locus starting from here, but in this diagram there is no root locus starting from minus 1, so this is not the case. Now again rule, as per the rule all root locus must start from pole. So 1 2 3 3 poles are there, but here all the roots are starting from origin. So here there is no root locus starting from this point and this point, so this point is not valid. And of course this point is also not valid. We have only this choice where three poles are residing at origin. So one root locus going in this direction and in this direction and in this direction. So three root locus going in different directions. So this is the answer for the given problem. So next question. For a unity feedback system with open loop transfer function g of s is equal to k divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. The root locus plot of the system is given. So four plots are given. We have to select the correct one. So here we will plot the pole zero map. So here s is equal to 0, 1 pole, and s is equal to minus 1 and s is equal to minus 2. So we have the pole zero map. We will begin with the rule. We will find the asymptote line, number of asymptote line. The formula is q is equal to p minus z modulus. So here number of poles are 3. So 3 minus, there is no zero. So here we have 3 asymptote line. So asymptote line is nothing but an angle, which will make some angle. So that angle we can calculate from here. So since we have 3 asymptote, the q can take the value 0, 1, 2. Since the q value is 3, so it can take the value 0, 1, 2. So first we will see theta, first theta. So that time the q is equal to 0, that is pi by 3. So first angle is pi by 3. When we take a q is equal to 1, that is theta 1, first one, q is equal to 1, that is 2 plus 1, 3, pi divided by 3, so that is equal to pi. When you take a q is equal to 2, q is equal to 2, so 2 plus 2, so 2 into 2, 4, plus 1, 5, pi by 3, that we can take as 300. So this is 60 degree and this is 180. So the asymptote line are 60 degree, one is 60 degree, another one is 180 degree, another one is 300 degree. Now we will find the centroid. Centroid form is, next formula is centroid. The formula is sum of poles minus sum of zeros divided by P minus Z. So the pole locations are 0, minus 1, minus 2. So here there is no 0 limit divided by the value is 3. So that is equal to minus 1. So centroid is minus 1. The centroid value is minus 1. So keeping centroid minus 1, this is minus 1. Draw the line 60 degree, 180 degree and 300 degree. So this is about a 60 degree line and this one is a 180 degree line and this one is a 360 degree line. So therefore so we concluded that the centroid point is somewhere here. So let me calculate the breakaway point. When we calculate the breakaway point, the breakaway point is somewhere here. You apply the breakaway point rule. Some point is somewhere here. So the direction of root locus starting from this point going towards this. The root locus starting from this point going towards this. They will meet at one point and then they will change the direction. They will change the direction. So this is the this line is the root locus. So among the given choices, this is the correct one. It's caught in the crossfire.